Welcome back, everyone. So a lot of work been done. You saw we had the engine out, we got the gas tank out, we had the fuel pump replaced, and now we're moving on to, you know, small bits as we wait for the wire harness to come back. So the wire harness was sent out, so there is a lead time on that because I guess a lot of guys are doing engine swaps at this point. So we sent it over to TCS and they're working on getting that back to us so we can just plug everything and put the engine back in. But in the meantime, you had seen all the stuff came out and I took the brakes off. So it was a good thing I kind of took the brakes out, because while I was doing that, I realized I had a broken rubber on one of the pistons. So, you know, I kind of, it's half disassembled here, and you know, I was just a little bit anxious to get it done. I came home from work one afternoon and kind of went crazy. So I got this piston out, and you know, I didn't have that on camera, but I'm going to kind of show you the basic idea. And this is a rear caliper, so if you look here, you see this rubber is all torn up, so we're gonna have to get this replaced. Right now, this has the e-brake mechanism attached to the caliper, so it's a little bit different. This is the first time I'm actually working on something like this. Normally you just use you know, like a c-clamp, and you push this piston in and it's all good. But I guess it's a little different design based on the e-brake, because if you look right here, if you press this thing, you see that thing moving, and this is basically e-brake assembly. So if you push on that, that's what locks the e-brake in place. So it's a little bit different. So looking at this might be a little bit confusing, but if you look at the assembled version, which is right here, you will see that this is what it looks like. So that's unassembled, that's disassembled, and this one is assembled, right? So if we look up at a couple of things, the rubber here, it's fully sealed, so it's not leaking or torn. And this is a dust boot. This one is obviously torn. And, you know, I wasn't sure how you replace this. I thought you just popped this out, but basically this piston can be removed and then you replace this boot. At least that's how I'm going at it. I couldn't find much information online, so kind of going in the dark here. So hopefully this video will help somebody out, because this is all new to me. Now, I bought this little cube tool, and you know, these pistons, you have to basically set it in place. There are different grooves, and we're using this side over here, and it's attached to a 3/8 ratchet. You basically put it in here, and then this is how you turn the piston. So you turn it anti-clockwise, and that's what it's going to remove the piston. So as you rotate this anti-clockwise, that is how you get this piece off. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. So we're going to work on this, replacing this dust boot right now. So let's jump right into it. Okay. All right, so I'm just trying to give a better idea how this works. So here is the ends of this tool, and I guess it's a caliper tool. So you see, when you get it into the piston, basically you turn this thing out, right? So that's how it basically works, to get the piston out. You just keep anti-clockwise and it turns right out and it pulls off the thread here. Now, this is all cleaned up, so bear in mind there is brake fluid inside here. So when you pull this out, and I just basically slipped it off of the rubber boot, you're gonna get a lot of brake fluid leaking out of this thing, right? So this is all leaked out already, and I cleaned this up. You could buy a new one. I kind of used my plastic blade here and went at it, and it came out pretty decent. So I think it's gonna be good. I'll try this, you know, worst case, if I put it and it doesn't work, then I'll probably just buy a whole new caliper. But for now, this is what we're working with. So here's the piston out and clean, and then here is the boot. Now, I got these parts, and again, rear caliper 93 MR2. This is a rebuild kit for the dust boot right here. I got this from Rock Auto. So the kit comes with, that's the part number again, and Raybestos, and it comes with the dust boot. It has the retaining ring. It has another washer or some O-rings here, but I'm not sure. I guess if you dig further into the caliper, I believe if you get to the e-brake section, because there is a C-clamp inside there, then you can change these boots. I'm not going to go that far, honestly. And then there is a seal for the piston, which is this one right here, the black one right here. So once you get this boot out, we'll see that, and I think I'm going to replace this. So for sure, I'm going to replace in the ring, the seal for the piston, and the dust boot, and we'll see how it goes with these two. Not sure if we're going to get there as yet, okay? So I kind of have it exposed here. If you look, you know, I'm trying to make sure I look at the orientation. So let me open this actually, so we can get the orientation off this rubber boot, the dust boot, because it's a little bit confusing when I look at it, and I want to make sure I put it back in the right way. So here's that boot, and I'm trying to figure out, do I put it in like this, or do I put it in like this? So I see some right in there. So when I put it, I mean, it's super confusing. You can't really tell. I'm going to make an assumption that it goes in like this, right? And based on what I'm seeing here, this looks like the logical way of doing it, but let's take it out and see what's up. I think the retaining clip, which is this guy, ends up going into this groove right here. So hopefully that's what it is. So let's just keep on moving along and discover as we go. So, you know, this was very hard to see. So if you use this little screwdriver, look, see the metal ring is deeply embedded inside here. So I just kind of pried on it until I saw this end. So now we're gonna go ahead and take out this clip. And there, it just went back in. So let me get back to that. There you go. So now we're gonna just pull this out. And there you go. Hope you can see that on camera. So we'll get this out. All right. And then this dust boot, like I said, it was over this portion right here. Right here was basically sitting on the end of the piston right here. Okay, so I just kind of stretched it and pulled it off. Okay, so the reinstall is going to be the opposite of that. Now this boot should just pop right out. So let's see, there you go. All right, so it came out and it basically fit into that groove. So let's look at these two now and see, one, just to make sure I got the right part, and two, look at the orientation. So I think this is pretty clear now. Yep, this is how it goes in. So essentially this rubber boot is gonna go back in here and the ring gets slipped right into this groove, okay? So I'm gonna clean this up a little bit and then we're gonna reinstall, but we were talking about the seal, and this O-ring or rubber seal, whatever you call it, it goes over the piston right here. So this is what really seals the piston so the fluid doesn't flow right out. This is the dust boot that prevents dust from getting into the system. So this should really fit into this groove. So we're gonna try to get that one out and put this one in. And I hope it's the right size, because I would have thought it would have fit a little bit more snug on this guy right here, and that's pretty loose. So I'm fingers crossed, hoping it's the right seal, but only one way to find out. So let's keep going at it. I'm gonna try to take this boot out. Let me see here. All right, let me get another tool and then we'll get right back on it. All right, so I got the screwdriver in this rubber and I'm gonna take it out, and I'm trying not to damage it because I may have to reuse it, because honestly the new one looks too big. So, but I don't know, so let's see. Here is the old one, and there is the new one, and it seems too big, the new one, but I don't know, the internal diameter looks to be about the same. Yep, see, I guess it is loose right there. So it seems a lot more loose, but I don't know, we'll see. This still seems pretty good. It's not cracked or anything. So I might just clean this off and reuse it. But let me put this one in just to test it out and see if it's gonna fit snug. And then we clean this thing up. I got some grease. For caliper grease, which is this Permatex right here. So we're gonna grease everything back up and put it in. Even these slide pins, if you look at these, they're pretty tight and they're supposed to move in and out, you know, a lot easier than this. So that could cause the brakes to bind and stuff. So so we're basically just gonna do an overhaul on this. But you know, like I said, this is not this is me trying to figure something out as we go with you guys watching along. Feedback is welcome if you see anything I'm doing wrong here or if you've done this before. But yeah, actually it looks like it will work. So let me clean it up and then I'll put it back in and I'll show you how I grease that all up. For now, it's just gonna be cleaning. So you don't need to watch that. So let me do that and then we'll come right back with you guys. So guess what? Nice fresh coat of paint. We had to put some more on. I had these painted like last week, but as I mentioned, once you pull this piston out, it's gonna spill a lot of brake fluid, and brake fluid is corrosive. So it just kind of ate some of that paint. So I just threw a quick coat of paint back on, so it's looking nice and sharp. And now we're gonna get the slide pins greased up. We're gonna put the sleeve in and the piston back in, and fingers crossed it goes without a hitch. So here goes. So let's get this pin out. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna push on this thing right here. It's gonna pop right out. So I'm just gonna pull it out like that. And I'm leaving those rubbers because they seem okay. So I'm gonna leave those rubbers in place. And I'm just gonna grease this thing and put it back in. Again, this is not a major overhaul. This is just to, you know, while you're at it, since I had to change that rubber because it was broken. So by no means am I teaching or showing people how to do this like the professional way. This is just, you know, as we wait for this wire harness to come in and we're doing odd jobs on the car, just to have something, some content, and this is what I'm doing. So, you know, I figure most of the guys watching just want to see what's going on with MR2, and this is, in my mind, the perfect way to keep everyone entertained until we jump right back on the engine install. So this should just slide right back in here. I'm trying not to tear this rubber boot, so I was taking my time. And there you go, it goes in. And it's just gonna catch, see right here, it just catches back into the grooves. So there you go. So I just push on it till it goes in, catches right here. And it's on pretty good here. So now it's all greased up. So before, you know, I had to push really hard. Now it just slides with less effort. So hopefully this should do the trick and the brakes should not bind or anything. Not that I think they were binding before, but clearly we had a broken rubber boot, so dust boot. So I'm gonna roll this one over. And the same thing applies to this guy. So if you look here, what I'm gonna do is just pop it off again like that. Clean this sleeve. And I think these should be packed with grease. So, you know, clearly this is an older car, so this hasn't had any service recently. So just gonna put some grease on this. And this is specific Caliper grease. I don't know if you can use other grease, but I bought what brake parts lubricant, synthetic. So got the good stuff. So I'm gonna put some of this on here. I don't know if I should go crazy to town with it, but what you see here is what I'm putting on. And now we're just gonna slide this back in and it's gonna catch right over this. Here, there you go, see that? So now and that's moving a lot better than it was. To be honest, I didn't even realize this moved before. So that's gonna be good. No, that was the easy part. Let's hope this section I'm gonna do is just as easy. So there are different ways to do it, or I've heard of folks doing it different ways. And one of the ways is basically you can put the rubber in first and then try to slide the dust boot over the piston, but I think that's going to be harder. So what I'm going to do is slip this thing over the piston and then kind of screw it in and then just push the bottom part here down and try to get the clip in. So I know that's probably confusing as I explain it, but let's do it so you'll see what I'm talking about. But before we get to this, I'm actually going to go ahead and use the new one. So here's the new piston seal. And I'm going to put some grease on this guy. And we're going to slip it into the groove. So it's kind of messy here. But I'm just going to grease this thing up. And then we're going to go into the second groove here. And just put it right back in. So this is the new one. I took the old one out. And you can see a small space. It's kind of hard to put the camera and show you guys what's going on. And then I got grease on it, so it's sliding all over the place. Let's see. Right. That's in the wrong spot. Essentially, there's an inner groove, so right there, there you go. I got the bottom in, I got the rest of it in. You see that groove right there? So essentially what I'm going to try to do is get the rest of this in that groove. Nice and smooth, so this may take a little bit of time, but I'm gonna video everything and we might cut some of this out. Oh, there you go. Oh, almost there, getting there. All right, let me play around with this and try to get it in, and then I'll show you when it's done. So it took a little bit of time, but we got the rubber in. Yeah, just gotta play with it, and yeah, it fits in pretty snug. So there's the seal, and let me point at it. So that's the rubber seal. So we took the old one out, and we put the new one in right here, okay? So now I gotta get the piston in. And like I said, this really goes in, and then it threads onto that guy right there. And we got to get this in nice and smooth. So this is without the rubber boot on. So I see how easy or hard it's going to be to get this thing threaded on. Because it, not saying that it can't, it was hard to get out, but it wasn't the easiest thing in the world to get it out. So I'm just going to try to thread this on. And then my strategy is I'm going to slip this boot over this first, catch the thread, and then kind of pull the rubber down and get the C-clip, the spring clip in. So that's what I'm gonna do. So let me see, my hands are so slippery with this grease. Let me see if I can catch this thread and see. The thread, and I can tell it's not going to be easy, but now I know why they sell new calipers. Just go buy a new one and take, get rid of this headache. I basically put the piston and just pushed it in and then used this tool to kind of catch the thread. I want to make sure that it's not, the threading goes in nice and smooth. So this feels about what it, the same pressure it was going in. So I'm going to leave it right there. And then what I was trying to mention before, now I'm going to take this rubber, slide it on, and then try to get it in this groove and then put the pin in and then turn this in. So I'm hoping that works. So let me grease this rubber up and we're gonna slide it on, and fingers crossed to what I'm thinking is gonna work, will work. So there you go. All right, so there you go, that rubber is in that groove. So now what I wanna do is basically take this and put it in there and then put the pin in between that groove, which is pretty tight, but hopefully that will do the trick. And I'm using this little wood thing here so I don't pierce this rubber in the process. This is pretty tight, especially at the bottom here. So wish me luck. So right in here is where it gets kind of tricky. So where you see this pin, this is where we're gonna have to slip that ring in place. And so far it looks like it's gonna work. So let's keep trying to get this guy in. And I know I sound kind of distracted, but obviously focusing on this guy and I'm trying to do this video. So if your brakes are bad, then maybe you find this interesting. If your brakes are not bad, then you're probably bored. So let me see if I can turn this. Actually, you know what? Maybe if I spin this, I'll get to the other side. So let's see. Yes and no, moved a little bit. Gotta get the back end in. It's almost there, but it's not there. But you guys get the basic idea of what I'm trying to do. So it's just a matter of getting this done and then we'll get the ring in. So let me play with it a little bit more again. I know we're cutting and going in and out, but this is YouTube. And if you do everything and show everything, you got to sit here for a long time. So let me try to show you the finished result. Let me just get this in and then we'll come right back with you. Wow, I finally got it in. So I use this Q-tip, large Q-tip, whatever, cleaning tip. I just kind of went around the edge like that until I got everything in. And the hardest part is in the back here because you can't really see it. I tried to turn this guy, but it wasn't working too well. It would turn, but it wouldn't turn the rubber on it. So, let's see. I didn't try turning it once I got everything in. Let me see if it would just kind of... Yeah, it turned a little bit. Let's see if I go the opposite direction. This tool is very clumsy, let me tell you. So the rubber is sitting in there. It moves a little bit, but not a lot, right? So anyways, you get the idea. We put it on here, slip it in there, and now we're gonna get this retaining clip on. So I'm just gonna push the retaining clip in. And as you can see, it just kind of disappears into the rubber. So I'm gonna use this guy again, hopefully strong enough. And basically I just put it in the groove right here. Yep, see that? See, it's in that little groove. And then we're gonna work it around. I think I'm gonna do this again because I wanna get it in the back, seated in the back, because I can't really see that very well back there. So I want it to disappear in the back and then put the clip in. So here it goes again. There you go. And now we're gonna get this side. And the back slipped out. Let's see if we can get it in. I take a chance with my little thing without hoping I don't pierce this rubber. Hope I don't pierce this rubber. So the whole idea is this thing should disappear into the rubber and I shouldn't be able to see it. So the fact that I'm seeing a little bit of it says to me it's not in 100%. So I'm just gonna play around with it here and hope I don't make it worse. Okay, that went too good. Looking a lot better now. So I can't really see the spring. So I think it slipped in between that groove. So let me turn this thing in and out and see. And hopefully that's what it is. So we're good to go. I don't know if I got a cheap tool, but this tool is not very easy to use. Or maybe I just need to put it in a vise or something. But anyways, this is how, if you had your, you were replacing your brakes and you had to put the pad in, you can't just push this thing with a C-clamp, you gotta turn it in. So you really need this tool to do the brake job on an MR2 in the rear. All right, so. That looks pretty decent to me. So if I compare it to the one that I didn't touch, so here's the one that I didn't touch, and that's kind of flat, but that probably makes sense being old. So all in all, I would say looks good. So we're gonna work with that. So hopefully that works. If we put it in the car, we hit the brakes and it doesn't work, then we know what went wrong. So anyways, that's a rear brake caliper dust boot, the main piston dust boot replacement. So there's not much that I saw on YouTube. So hopefully this will be helpful to someone. And hopefully I did it right too. So you saw the whole process from start to end. So comments are very welcome. And it's hot here in Florida. So we'll be moving on next. We'll get the intercooler into the car. So I have the TCS intercooler. I'm gonna get that installed and basically just getting the engine bay ready. So as the wire harness comes in, put the engine in and we just keep moving along. So thanks for watching. We got a little bit more subscribers, so we're building. And again, I love comments. So please, if you have any comments, feel free to share with me. So far it's been good. Haven't gotten any negative comments, so I think we're doing right. So thank you so much and have a great day.